It's lovely to have you here.
Nice to be here on your talk show.
Congrats on the special. It's great.
Thank you. Thank you
really
for saying that. That's
and,
very nice to say.
Everybody should check it out. Now, obviously, you were following the presidential campaigns. You had a great bit about Trump way before, years before he was pretending to run for president.
Yes. He was still an odd person back then.
Yes.
This was in 2007 when he was just doing Celebrity Apprentice. And he was like, oh, that's about the weirdest he'll ever be. And then he topped that.
Yeah, he really did.
No, but I said, I'm repeating myself, but what I said back then was that, to me, like, Trump is not a rich man. Donald Trump is like what a hobo imagines a rich man to be. Like, Trump was walking around under an underpass, and he heard some guy like, oh, as soon as my number comes in, I'm gonna put up tall buildings with my name on them. I'll have fine golden hair. And a TV show where I fire Gene Simmons with my children. And Trump was like, that is how I will live my life.
Like, what is your take on this so far?
Well, it's in keeping with him. Because when he makes a decision, he must think to himself, like, what would a cartoon rich person do? Run for president. So what's weird to me is, like, that the success kind of continues for him. But I realized something as to what might be causing that. You know, I watched two episodes of Family Feud back-to-back every day on the Game Show Network.
Sure.
Have I told you that? Yeah, okay, yeah. We talked about this? Okay.
Yeah, we have, yes.
Those of you that have never seen Family Feud, it's a nightly game show where two families, a white family and a fun family, square off, and they're supposed to answer a white family and the family you root for. And then they're supposed to pick the 5, 7, or 9 most probable answers that are from a survey of 100 people.
Yeah.
And I know you're like, why are you re-explaining the rules of Family Feud?
I'm mostly just like, what a wonderful set of rules.
Yeah. Well, they are wonderful, but no one follows them because people on that show are just saying things.
Yeah.
Like, if the show was called, Hey, That's Possible, a lot of people would be good at Family Feud. So, here's what happens when you watch two episodes of Family Feud back-to-back every day on the Game Show Network, GSN. You don't become dumb. A lot of people might think you become dumb. You actually start to feel smart. Because you feel smarter than the people on Family Feud. But once your bar for intelligence becomes the people on Family Feud, two things happen. One, you become very, very dumb.
Yeah.
And secondly, you start to think that the people that are good at Family Feud are smart. You know, they'll be like, name a vehicle that would come to a fire. And they're like, fire truck. And you're like, whoa, this guy's good at fast money. So that's what's happened with Donald Trump. He's not good at running for president. He's just good at Family Feud. And these other people are terrible at Family Feud.
Right.
So when the Steve Harvey of this election is like, name something that is bothering Americans, and Ted Cruz is like, brrr, Benghazi. But then Trump is like, brrr, all the problems, and that's the number one answer up on the board. So he's pretty good at it.
He's good.
He's good at Family Feud.
He's good at Family Feud.